Hey guys, it's Kirk from IMMusic. We're going to do something different here in two, three, maybe four videos. We're going to feature a Ketron SD40 and connecting it up to our Wersi Sonic running OAX and some of the things you can do when you combine those two instruments. Most importantly, we want to thank AJ from Ketron USA for the eval unit that you're going to see featured in this video and the next two or three that we do. Thanks again, AJ, for the use of the SD40. If you remember in our first video when we showed you powering up the Ketron, this is the first screen that you will see. Notice on the left, master is highlighted, and that's what we're going to select just to get you up and running with a very basic configuration. It's going to split the keyboard, and the left-hand side will allow us to trigger chord changes in the accompaniment section or styles, and the right-hand side will be able to select a voice, again, using all the buttons on the Ketron. We'll come back later and show you a more advanced configuration where we can actually change the sounds from the Wersi. That'll probably be in the next video. After you hit that master button, you're going to see a screen that looks just like this. I'm going to call this the home screen. Over on the left, you see a yellow box, 8-beat 1. That is the default style that gets selected. Over on the right, you see classic grand piano. Again, a default sound that gets selected. And right in the middle, you see it says the keyboard is split at C3. That's middle C on our upper keyboard. The other thing I didn't mention is when you hit that master setup, it defaults or configures the Ketron to receive data on MIDI channel 1. So let's go take a look at what we have to do on the Wersi side to get a user sound set up on our upper keyboard transmitting on MIDI channel 1. Okay, so now we're on the home screen of our Wersi. Excuse me. And we're going to go to sounds right here. Here we go. We're going to go to user sounds. And I'm going to click user. And these are the default blank sounds that Wersi gives you. Remember we showed you we would be using MIDI out 1. Well, that's this guy right here. This one's MIDI out 2 on the back of the organ. And this one's if you're going to do MIDI over USB. Remember we said the Ketron will be on MIDI channel 1. And look, magically, that's the way this is set up for. So I'm going to pick this guy and hit enter. And now notice that sound shows up on our upper keyboard. Let me double click that and show you a little bit more about what's going on there. So you notice the MIDI channel is set to 1. And over here, hang on, let's click this so you can see it a little bit better. Okay, so MIDI channel is set to 1, and it is again going to output number 1. So by default, we don't have to really do anything, okay? So I'm just going to leave it as it's the default settings for right now. We'll run down, we'll shoot a real short video clip of trying to play something on the Ketron using our new standard MIDI external 1 output, which is sending on channel 1. Be right back. Let me show you real quick again. We're going to switch back. Notice on the left-hand side, we picked a style called Bossa Light. And over on the right-hand side, you see we picked a flute sound. So we've changed the style and the lead instrument. And we're going to ask the organ folks not to pick on us just yet. You can pick on us, but not yet. Because at this point, we're playing on the upper keyboard only, and quite honestly, we didn't even sit down on the bench to play a couple bars of a tune. What we want to show you here is the basic function of playing the Ketron from our Sonic. Okay, so that's a very simple look at a very simple configuration. And we invite you to watch our next video where we will show playing upper lower pedals on the organ side along with our Ketron. As always, thanks for watching.